cities, the sanctuary cities, come on in, one and all. There's so many reasons, you know, that when you have this huge influx,
yeah,
it's a positive for the Democrats because, you know, it's they're going to be counted in the census, more federal money.
Yep.
Go ahead.
Oh, I was just going to say, yeah, and, you know, traditionally these new, or the Democrats at least, are hoping that they will in turn show up at the voting boxes and vote for Democrats the rest of their lives. Of course, illegal aliens cannot vote in federal elections. Shouldn't even be a case here. The case here is for the American people and the American workers who are not being taken care of. Our highways, our hospitals, our education system, we're bust. I mean, we need to fix up our country. We don't have money to take care of Central America, for example, and you've got people coming in this country lawfully that are, you know, just, you know, wondering, why did I go through the legal process and pay the money, go through the health, you know, test so I could get here legally, when these people are hopping across the border, turning themselves in, and then all of a sudden, yay, they're finding themselves in America for the rest of their lives.
And of course, they say, they will be dependent,
mm-hmm,
strictly on the government.
Yeah,
so that's almost like socialism, isn't it?
That is. And you know what, just for an example, this year alone, so the first 3 months, so January, February, March, the immigration offices have put out that there are 17,900 migrants, 17,900 migrants who have failed to show up for their court date this first 3 months of this year. So already we're seeing 18,000 not going. So they're saying, well, give us a pass, we'll come back to court. You and I both know, most of the listeners here know as well, that they are never coming back. And if they do, they approximately 89 to 94 don't qualify for asylum, and then they get deported back. So, you know, we're seeing the numbers up front. And it's something that really is a crisis for our country, because what they know, they have numbers. They're just plowing down this, you know, in southern Mexico over their border over the weekend. They plowed over, you know, just pushed the fence down and walked right over Mexican police. That's breaking and entering in most countries. Apparently in this country, we're going to reward you with, you know, free healthcare, education, housing, and whatever you may need as you grow old in this country. Mm-hmm.
But let me ask you this before we get into that. You know, there's this old saying about, be careful what you ask for. You've heard that before.
Yeah.
Do you think that this was just a marketing ploy for the base? Or has President Trump outwitted his critics once again?
Well, this is, I believe, you know, and I don't have firsthand knowledge of what the president was thinking, wish I did. But I, you know, people inside Department of Homeland Security and people who are bureaucrats are stating that, you know, this was going to cause a lot of trouble for the president, trouble he didn't need, that it was likely that it would be illegal for the president to, you know, implement this type of plan and get these, you know, migrants, you know, off the border and into sanctuary cities. However, I mean, you have every Democrat on TV and every liberal mainstream media outlet saying, this is illegal, it's illegal. But have you heard one of these people say, because you look at section 0.08316 of the code, this states that illegals cannot be shipped to sanctuary. There is no law stating the president cannot do what he is proposing to do. He's calling their bluff. And he's trying, I mean, he's desperate at this point because the border has become such a wreck. He's figuring now that he's going to say, we're just going to dump these people in Los Angeles and Hollywood. And now you've got Hollywood star Cher saying, whoa, wait a minute, we don't want them. We can't take care of them here. So somebody always ends up having to pay. And in this case, it's the taxpayer that will pay for the added burden, because the majority of these people are not coming that where they graduated college somewhere and they have top rate, you know, IT skills that this country needs. That's simply not the case. These are people that will be working. Most likely, a lot of them don't even have like a sixth grade education on top of all of that. So we're looking at people that are going to take from the system rather than put into the system.
I was reading almost word for word what you just said there. The truth is, illegal immigrants are a net drain on society. They are not people with PhDs and piles of seed money looking to create the next great startup.
Yep.
They're largely people who can't speak English with little to no education, many illiterate in their native language.
Yep.
They will become the servant class for the liberal elite and their wealthy donors.
Yep.
But more importantly, as I said a while ago, to the left, they will be dependent on the government.
Yep.
You know, isn't it amazing how if we would just obey the laws on the books, we wouldn't be going through any of this. But
absolutely. Yeah.
All of a sudden, go ahead.
I was going to say, absolutely. And Sarah, the president's spokesperson, Sarah Huckabee Sanders, came out on Sunday and said, look, that the president, and I'm going to read this quote, the president's actually trying to enforce laws, not go around them. We're a country of laws, and we have a president who supports that and is not asking anybody to do anything outside those bounds. Now, on the Sunday talk shows and in Friday afternoon, while they were wrapping the news up about this, you know, a lot of these people kind of came out and said that, look, you know, until the president comes up with a new policy, he can't just simply make statements, and it's irresponsible to go to Twitter and make these statements. Well, I've got a fact here for these Democrats that are on TV railing against the president. The president enforces the law. He doesn't make the laws. Congress, which would be Nadler and all the and Adam Schiff and that entire crew, those people are the ones that actually make the law. So maybe they want to step away from the microphones and actually make the law that they would like, pass it through Congress so the president can sign this. The president is following the law, much like Joe Arpaio, which is I've talked about numerous times here. He followed the law in Arizona, and he told lawmakers, you want to change the law, I'll follow that new law. But as it sits, I'm following the law in this state and federal law in the country. So, I mean, this is where the disconnect is.
And Obama and Eric Holder said, we're going to stop that sheriff. And they succeeded. You know, George Soros helped get him voted out of there.
Yeah.
See, back in 1952, listeners, Truman, all right, pushed the Federal Immigration National Act, 1952, went through Congress. It's in the law. It's Section 8, USC 1324. And think about this. You know, President Trump is trying to follow this law. But see, this is now, oh, this is an extreme law. Wow.
Yeah.
Listen to this. But this is the one they're breaking. Any U.S. citizen that knowingly assists an illegal alien, provides them with employment, food, water, or shelter, how cruel, has committed a felony. City, county, or state officials that declare their jurisdictions to be open cities, counties, or states are subject to arrest, as are law enforcement agencies who choose not to enforce this law.
Yeah.
It's on the books.
It's on the books. Again, he's just...
Following it.
He's tried over the past 18 months to work with Republicans and Democrats to move this immigration situation forward. I mean, he promised that he was going to grant more DACA recipients their green cards, 2 million, I believe was the number, and the Democrats went, no, we want more than that now, but they were seeking 1 million before. So you're saying this is basically being a political football, and the American people, they see this. You cannot see the pictures of what's going on at that border right now and say that this is not right. I mean, parents and young people that are going to schools, they're seeing the effects of this. The, you know, the cities and states, you know, most everyone is operating in the red, including the federal government. So people are recognizing that they can't run their lives that way. How can the federal government run its life that way? And when it comes down to it, once we start calling the bluff, or once the president starts calling the bluff and sending these illegals into, let's say, Los Angeles County, you know, what do you think the schools are going to be like there? How do you think that's, is that not going to disrupt the schools?
Well,
in Los Angeles County, if they send 10,000 new children to their school, I mean, of course it's going to have a major effect. And now I think you're seeing some of the Democrats, some of the blue dogs in the middle actually backing up for it, go, wait a minute, this may not be a great idea. But I just, you know, something has to be done, and something has to be done to show that these people coming up and tearing down Mexico's border and making their way to the United States, that there are consequences for what they're doing. And consequences are not a green card with a job and free health insurance. That's not the consequence. That's the magnet, and they know they're coming up and do it. We know 17,900 who were taken into custody in the first 3 months have not showed up for their court date. So now we have 17,900 fugitives running around our country.
Yeah. You know, and as white people have said, you know, that English is the language that, what is it, the glue, that's it. Yeah, the glue that holds this nation together.
Mm-hmm.
And boy, when you hear about all the different languages spoken, just like in the Los Angeles
yeah.
schools, Denver surprised me. You know, I get a guy named Frosty Wooldridge comes on quite a bit, and I mean, 100 and something different languages just
yeah.
in, you know, the city of, you know, in Denver, Colorado. Okay?
Yeah. Well.
So then they have problems down here. You know, the class size.
Yeah.
And all the languages being spoken, and here you have the union saying, "Oh yeah, we'll take care of it. You know, give us 4 more years."
Yeah.
Meanwhile, can we get some more union members?
Yeah. Well, I think that there is a way forward with this. I mean, I really believe that there's a way forward for this. And I think the first thing that needs to happen is we don't need to be building any fixed structures down along the border. We can put up a whole bunch of different tents, kind of like refugees stay at when they're in other countries around the globe. We can ensure that we get more judges and asylum people, get lawyers down to the border so they can adjudicate some of these cases and turn around these migrants that are trying to say they're coming for political asylum. If they don't qualify, then we could turn around and send them back home without releasing them to the interior of this border. And also, you know, we've got a lot of people inside the United States that are overstayed on visas. You know, ICE tends to know where quite a few of these people are. And I'm thinking that, you know, we're going to hear any day now that the administration is going to, you know, allow the ICE officials to go out and find these people that were slated for deportation and actually deport them and start this slow process of evicting people out, forcing them to get into line and prove their case in a lawful manner, just like the other, you know, millions and millions of immigrants who've come to this country have before that. I mean, it's just, we are lawless, and the fact that we catch and release these people is not going to stop the flow of these migrants from El Salvador, Honduras, and Guatemala are the primary, but you're gonna start seeing them from Nicaragua and Costa Rica. You're gonna see them come from all these other countries if they see how successful this is. And America just can't afford it. I mean, to think that we're going to allow more than 2 million people into this country this year, 2 million, if you count the people that are coming with the migrants, because they said more than 1 million of them are going to be here within a year. So on top of the 1.5 we do, lawfully, now we're going to have 2 to 2.5 million people per year coming to the country. The country can't withstand that. We don't have the housing for that. No, I'm not adding on the visas. No. I'm just saying the people that are actually crossing the border seeking asylum. Yeah.
Hey, real quick, like, let's talk real quick about this challenge in the Ninth Circuit Court. Finally, we got a good one. That's the worst court in the world.
Yeah. Well, it's kind of ludicrous to think that one district court judge sitting on the Ninth Circuit could actually tell the President of the United States that when people come through and apply for asylum, that the president's administration cannot ask the asylum seekers to stay in Mexico while their claims are processed, especially when Mexico has said that they will allow them to stay in their country and give them the opportunity to work in that country. So the Ninth Circuit, of course, really wants to, you know, get out there and really go after the president on this. And this is something where it was migrants filed it. And these folks on Friday were told that there was, that the courts did not have a, could not withstand an appeal at this time, and that the migrants would have to wait in Mexico.
You know, a moment ago, and we're coming up on that break, you were talking about ICE, and it's amazing how the left, you know, turns things the wrong way. You know,
yeah.
ICE, oh, that's a dirty word, you know, and you let one judge do this and do that. But I think you're the one that suggested, you know, the Immigration Customs Enforcement.
Yeah.
That we should, you should, I think you're the one that said, let's call it the National Immigration Customs Enforcement, and then it would be NICE.
Yeah.
And boy, they would be upset about that. Were you the one that came up with that as we go into this break?
We may have.
I'll give you the credit.
Okay.
Right? But luckily, Kimberly Dvorak, the wise, intelligent Kimberly Dvorak, will be back and wrap things up. And we've